Let's go through 10 new features that will have you standing on the shoulders of giants and saving a huge amount of time, especially the last one. It's actually insane. So let's get into this in reverse order, starting with number 10, which is Snaplet is now open source. Snaplet was a great way to generate production-like data based on your Postgres schema, which was great for local development or seeding data in your staging environment. Wait, why does he keep saying was so weirdly? Unfortunately, Snaplet have closed the doors, but a bunch of the team have joined Supabase and have open sourced three core tools. We have Copycat, which generates that fake data and is deterministic, so the same inputs will always give you the same outputs. Snaplet Seed, which generates data based on the schema of your database, so you can get realistic example data that matches the exact type and constraints of your tables and columns. And then Snapshot, which can be used to take a full copy of the current state of your database, basically an advanced version of pgdump and pgrestore. Okay, number 9. Actually, before we do that, I just wanted to run a little experiment. If you're watching me full screen, make it smaller so you can see that like button. And then when I say, go ahead and hit that like button, did it just light up? If so, let me know in the comments. YouTube is trialing this with a few channels, and I want to know if we're one of them. Okay, number 9, PG Replicate. This allows you to replicate or stream the changes to both your data and the schema of your database, so you can copy the state of your database over to something like BigQuery or DuckDB. And then as data is changed in the database, those changes are streamed to that other service, which now has a perfect copy of your entire Postgres database. Number 8, Vec to PG, which is a CLI tool for efficiently migrating data from a vector database like Pinecone or Quadrant, or is it Quadrant? I don't know. But now you can run this single command to migrate data from Pinecone, for example, and the CLI will handle writing every row to your Postgres database and will automatically generate those vectors using the PG vector extension. Number 7, and this one is a huge time saver. We now have an official Supabase extension for VS Code and GitHub Copilot. This means you can chat with Copilot and ask questions about your Supabase project, so we could get a list of all of our tables, look at the structure of a particular table, or get help writing a new migration. Number 6, official support for the Supabase Python library. This one was kickstarted by the amazing Supabase community and was widely adopted by the AI and machine learning folks building with Python and Supabase. And now we're super excited to announce official support across all of the packages that make up the Supabase platform. Number 5, and we're down to one hand, which means it's time to talk about log drains. You can now configure Supabase to drain your logs to another logging or monitoring service like Datadog, or anything that supports HTTP post requests. This means you can integrate your Postgres logs into an existing observability pipeline and notify the right people when something goes wrong. Number 4, we now have real-time authorization for broadcast and presence. This means you can write RLS policies to secure your real-time messages in the same way you can secure your table data or file storage, so only the people you want to be notified get notified. Security! Speaking of security, number 3 is third-party authentication. You can configure your Supabase client to use a third-party authentication service like Auth0, Amazon Cognito, or Firebase, which means you get to benefit from all the amazing tools in the Supabase stack, even if you're using another authentication service. It also makes migrating really easy. Number 2, you can now build your own foreign data wrappers with Wasm. So foreign data wrappers allow you to query external data through Postgres and join it with other tables as if they were all just in the same database. And number 1, which is just so unbelievably cool, is postgres.new. This allows you to build out an entire database directly in your browser with a ChatGPT-like interface. But for that demo, you should just go watch it from the guy who built it. Greg shows us how to create a database and its data from a CSV, and then use AI prompts to modify its structure and write some pretty complex queries. The whole thing basically just lives in a text file, so you can chuck it wherever you want, like S3. But until next time, keep building cool stuff.